Hello, my dear students. I hope you people are fine. So let us continue with our criterias that the open source software should follow. In our previous video, we have completed with the first three criterias. In this video, let us move on to the fourth criteria, that is the no discrimination against the person and a group of persons. This means that the software should be available to all the public irrespective of their identity. That means the software shouldn't make any discrimination against the programmers or the non-programmers at the time of downloading. The software should be available to both the programmers as well as the non-programmers. Okay, this is what is no discrimination against the persons and the group of persons. Moving on to the fifth criteria, that is no discrimination against the fields. This means the license must not restrict anyone from making use of the program or the software in the specific field. For an example, it may not restrict any program from being used in the business field or the genetic field or research field or any medical field or irrespective of any field, the license should allow the software or the programmer could be easily available. It shouldn't say, the software shouldn't say that you belong to a medical field, hence the software cannot be downloaded. There should be no any such kind of discrimination against any of the field. Irrespective of the any field it might be, the software could be easily made available. That means easily it could be made downloadable. Moving on to the next criteria, that is the distribution of license. This means the rights that are attached to the program or the software must apply to all to whom the program is redistributed without the need for the execution of an additional license by those parties. For an example, think I have purchased the modified software from one of the person, maybe from one of my friend. When my friend had downloaded the software from the internet, whatever the rights or the license was given to that person, the same rights or the licenses will be provided to me also without having to use any additional license by me in order to use those modified software. This means if my friend is having the original software which he has downloaded from the internet and he has done his modification, he has applied certain few more programming techniques and he has developed a new modified software and he want to sell it to me. When I purchase that software from my friend, whatever the rights or the licenses it was being applicable for him when he had downloaded the original software, the same license and the same rights should be applied to me also. When the software or the program get redistributed means reselling, when the redistribution takes place irrespective of any of the person to all the parties, whoever will buy the remodified software from that particular person, to all the same equal rights and the license should be applied and there should be no any additional license should be given to the new user in order to make use of that particular software. So this is about the distribution of the license. Moving on to the next criteria, license must not be a specific to a product. I'll explain this one with a simple example. Consider one software that has a license. The rights that are being attached to that program or the software shouldn't depend upon the programs that are part of that particular software distribution. Suppose if the programs from that software, if it is extracted and it has been used for some reason, and if the program, if it is distributed to some another software within the terms of license, means the programs which are part of that particular software, if it is being used or it is being given to some other software, a copy of the programs is given to some other software within by using the terms of license, then all the people or the parties to whom that program was redistributed should have the same rights as that of the original software distribution had. Okay, that means the distributed program to whom all I have distributed that program module, all should have the same kinds of rights, okay, or the license that the original software would had. Sixth point and seventh point are quite similar, but sixth point, that is distribution of license, makes it clear that there should be no any additional, you know, license should be given to the new user. Okay, there should be no any additional license to be given to the new user to make the use of modified software. Whereas in the seventh point, it is made it clear that whatever the modified software we are having and to whom all it is distributed, it should have the same license or the rights as of that of the original software had. Understood? Moving on to the next criteria, that is license must not restrict other software. So here there should be no any restrictions to all the software which are available. Okay, usually restrictions will not be implemented on all kinds of software. Instead, restrictions are implemented only on the licensed software. So there may be licensed software, means like they may be payable software. Usually there will be free software also. Okay, like free browser, like Mozilla and all, they are free browser, wherein you can't implement any kind of restrictions on them at the time of downloading or at the time of redistribution or at the time of making any kind of modifications. You cannot implement any kind of restrictions on them. But there will be some restrictions on the payable software on which certain restriction will be implemented. Or some may allow you to download those freely available softwares, but they may not allow for making any kind of modification. These are certain kind of restriction. Certain software, you know, may allow, like, you know, Google Chrome. Google Chrome is a freely web browser. It will allow you to download into your computer system, but it will not provide its source code to make modifications. Hence, there are certain restrictions imposed on the licensed software. That means we can implement the restrictions only on licensed software, not on all the kinds of software. All the kinds of software means like Mozilla browser. We can't implement the restrictions at all because it is freely available and the source code is also available, which allow for the modification also. So this is all about the license must not restrict other software. It can restrict only to the licensed software. Moving on to the last criteria, license must be technology neutral. This means there is no provision for the license to predict on any individual technology or the style of interface. This means there is no provision mentioned in any of the license that it may predict that what kind of technology or the style of interface can be used in any of the software, any of the new developing software. Understood? Because firstly, the software will be designed by using any of the technology, and then the user interface, and then the license will be provided to that particular newly developed software. So software license cannot decide what kind of technology the software has to make use in order to build any kind of applications. Okay, first the software will be designed along with the user interface. User interface is nothing but it is acting as an interface between the software and the user. Okay, so that, like, you know, maybe GUI based, so that the user can easily accessible through the software commands, icons, that is, you know, which is compatible between the software and the user, that is user interface. Understood? So no any license will predict any kind of technology, which technology should be made used by the software. Moving on to the next point in this, that is, software that is free as well as the open belongs to a category known as FOSS, that which stands for free and open source software, where the term free emphasizes, that is where emphasizes, or it may give more importance for the freedom for the users to use the software freely, where the term open software emphasizes on technical progress, because the open source software allows for modification and the redistribution of the software. Any software that is freely available plus it's an open software belongs to a category known as free and open source software. I hope all the criterias are clear to you. Okay. Now let me make certain differences between the open source software and the free software. Open source software actually refers to the software whose source code is easily available to the customer. It can be modified and redistributed without any limitations or the permissions. This open source software may come free of cost or with a payment of nominal charges that has to be given to the developers. So the developers may charge in the name of the development or the support of software. Certain examples of open source software, like based upon application software, we have certain examples: 7-Zip, Eclipse, okay, GIMP, Chromium, Blender, Mozilla, Firefox, Open Service. Open softwares are also based upon certain operating system. Android is an open source software, which may be completely free or it may be a payable amount, a minimal amount of payable to the developers. Linux operating system, FreeBSD, React OS, Haiku, FreeDOS, okay, and certain programming languages are these which may come open source. What is this free open source software is? It is those software which comes completely free of cost. It doesn't even consist of any kind of, you know, payable amount. So that is, you can also call it as FOSS, or you can also call it as FLOSS, that is FLOSS, which actually stands for free, library or livery and open source software, where the library and livery both actually gives the meaning of the freedom. That's why we call it as the free open source software, which you can use the software without any paying any kind of the cost. Okay. This FLOSS is actually used to refer to the computer software which is both free as well as the open source software, which provides freely licensed copy to use, study or change the software in any way, and the source code is openly shared by all the people, okay, and they can have an improvement over the software. Often the both free software and open software can refer to the same program or the source code. Open source software also provides the same source code, and the free software also provide the same source code, but actually each of them gives the different importance on different aspects. Free software give mainly importance for the freedom for the user in order to use the software without any kind of payment, whereas the open source software, okay, gives the importance for the technical progress, because that someone should download the software, someone has to make the modification, because most of the technical things are being involved there. So in case of free software, the user will may download the software and he may not do the modification. Modification is allowed, he may or he may not do. But in case of the open source software, the user can modify in terms of technical progress. So sometimes OSS, that is open source software, could be payable software for the developers. Okay, so this is about the OSS and the FLOSS, that is FLOSS. Moving on to the next one, that is the GNU. Okay, GNU actually is a kind of a free operating system. Okay, it's a free operating system. It refers to the GNUs actually, but not an Unix. Now what is this actually is? This GNU, it is called as the GNUs but not Unix, because its design is similar to the Unix operating system, but actually it differs from the Unix by being free operating system, and it does not contain any kind of Unix code in it. Hence, it is called as GNUs but not an Unix. Understood? Now, why it is called as GNUs but not an Unix? Because the development of GNUs was being initiated by a man called as here Richard Stallman in the 1983, where his primary focus to have the free software made available to the public. So before, when these different kinds of software were there in the earlier days, those softwares were not free. That means the source code was not available. That means that other public, other non-programmers, they didn't had any chance, you know, in order to build a software or develop a software of their own ideas. So this man, Richard Stallman, he proposed an idea that all the softwares over the internet should be freely available with the source code so that the public can make the modifications in that particular software and use it accordingly as they want in their computer system. So they can change the computing task of that particular software and they use it for their own purpose rather than how the software was initially built. So he proposed a kind of a free operating system called as the GNU, which was, the design was very much similar to the Unix. So certain basics he had taken, here design was lookout was like, you know, Unix operating system. But it's not an Unix operating system. It doesn't involve any kind of, you know, Unix code in it. Hence, it has been called as GNU, refers to GNUs, but not an Unix. It actually used the logos, shows a GNU. This is an animal actually, you know, which actually resembles and living in freedom. That means it represents the GNU is an operating system which is a free of cost. It's a free of, so free software which can be openly used by, used and shared by all the public. Okay, moving on to the next one, organization, that is the FSF, which stands for Free Software Foundation. This Free Software Foundation is a non-profit organization that was being created for the purpose of supporting the free software movement. Understood? So when this GNU had operating system had come into project, you know, come into existence, it was not completely implemented. He actually founded a foundation known as the FSF, that is a Free Software Foundation. Richard Stallman founded this in the year of 1985 in order to support the GNU's project and GNU's license. See, any software that has to come into existence should abide by certain license. Then he started finding for the developers, software developers, to write the free software for the GNU's project. Understood? So that the free software could be shared to the public. So this is the foundation that will be that actually search for the software developers who will write the free software in order to support all the GNU's projects and the license. And hence the GNU's operating system was being, you know, was in existence. Moving on, these are all the different types of organizations that were supporting for the free software should be made available to the public. Moving on to the next one, that is Open Source Initiative. This is also a kind of an organization that was dedicated to the cause of promoting the open source software. That means this is also one of the organization that was, you know, dedicated in saying that there should be many of the open source software so that the source code of these software should be made available for the public in according to use those software according to the wish of the user, so that they can modify it and use according to their needs. Okay, a person named as the Bruce Perens and Eric Raymond were the founders of this OSI, that is Open Source Initiative, that was being founded in the February 1998. What exactly this OSI did is, this Open Source Initiative, it actually specifies the criteria for the OSS. That previously 9 criterias what we have studied, right? That is derived works, no discrimination against the persons to persons or a group of persons. Okay, no discrimination against any fields. Okay, distribution of license. License must be not be specific to a product. All those criterias are being listed or thus specified by this open source initiative. It's an organization which would properly defines the terms and specification to the open source software. That means what kind of a license, what are the criteria that any open source software should follow whenever it is getting distributed. Distributed in the sense making it available to the public over the internet. Okay, means the OSS will not just provide the access to the source code, but it also provides the criteria and the license that the open source software distribution has to follow, which has been listed or given by this open source initiative. If any, maybe Linux, as it's an example for the open source software operating system, or Mozilla, it's an open source software, it should be completely abided by all those 9 criterias which are being listed by this open source initiative, apart from the source code made available to the public. Okay, so these are certain kinds of organization that are helping the free software or the OSS software, you know, to make those source code available to the public. Okay, so next topics we will cover in our next video. Take care of yourself, understand the concepts clearly, solve the assignment accordingly. Thank you, students.